after, you know, coach giving me some time off, told me to think about it and everything, what happened was that I really realized, you know, how much I love playing with my teammates, you know, and how much fun it is to win, and just all of the perks of being a national champion. And obviously I wasn't, you know, a clear-cut first-round pick, so coming back for me, it was mainly because, you know, coach, my teammates, the Louisville campus, the community, graduating, and I never really gotten a, you know, an official goodbye, so that kind of like stuck with me. I wanted to do senior night, so it was just really a lot of things as a person that I wanted to do. But after practice, you know, being with Slime, Jordan, Montrez, always mad at somebody, or, you know, Kevin, just everything. It's like I don't think I'll be able to get that somewhere else. And I love the win. And with the group we got coming back, I want to go out as a winner as well as get my degree. So I'm very happy, and I'm happy I finally got it off my chest. And after doing all the pros and the cons of, you know, staying or going, the pros of staying were so much better than the pros of leaving. But what was crazy was that all my pros that I put down for me leaving was very immature. You know, you have to put the work in to get better. You have to do this and you have to do that. Those are all challenges. And I felt like, along with coach, we both felt I'd be running away from getting better and maturing as a player if I just left and not wanted to get any better. So this season, I have some new goals. I have some new challenges. Coach writes down goals for me every year, and I'll reach them. And whatever it takes to win, I'm all in for.
When did you make the decision? Your dad, after the game, was pretty. It sounded like you all had talked about it before that, and he was pretty outspoken about it. When did you make the decision that you were in fact going to come back?
Honestly, it never was. As much smoke as you think I was like blowing to everybody, it was really serious. I mean, I really didn't know. One day I told coach, I want to come back. Then the next day I sent coach a big conclusion. But I was really unsure, and not up until, you know, when I woke up this morning, I knew that I was definitely gonna come back. And the time before that, maybe 3 days previous to this, I was really, you know, thinking about my teammates, how much I missed them, and, you know, my room is dirty. I'd have had to clean everything up before I had to leave. So,
that's a great reason.
So just everything adding up just made it that much more special.
How much weight, Russ, is off your shoulders now? Because I know this decision was really weighing on
you. I mean it was a lot. You know, I mean, you're talking about. It was a lot of you know, attention that I didn't really, you know, want per se. I just wanted it to, you know, just to be a normal decision, but that's what comes with it. So, but it's definitely a lot of weight. You know, I go out to eat, and it's all right. Your meal's such and such. Are you coming back? Like, or I'll be watching a game or something, and I'll get that question. But it's really nice that I have it off my back, and I can focus on getting better for next year.
How much of this is old school? A lot of players go early. You're going to be old school in the state for the full 4 years.
Well, my mom is a big academic woman. She doesn't get talked about a lot, but she's helped me throughout high school. She was there for me in elementary, junior high school. She's had a big academic influence on my life, and I know how important it is to, you know, graduate, and I want to do some things off the court, and most importantly, if I were had to leave today, I don't think I would have gotten those opportunities if I would have decided to stop playing pro ball. Because I wouldn't have had a degree, you know. So I wanted to start my pro ball career with a college degree. That's very important to me.
Let's talk about being a leader. Coach mentioned that. What do you want to do with this team, and what have you learned from Peyton?
You know, it's after being under Peyton's wing, Preston's wing, Chris Smith, and Kyle. I know how difficult it was, because even for those guys, it's like, man, like, we just gotta pull it together. Like, they'll come to us and they'll call meetings, but it's a role that I've never experienced and I've never got a chance to showcase. But to be fair, I don't think I was deserving of that position. But I feel like this year I could do more of that, and I could get better in that category. And that's what I want to do as a person, just kind of mature in all areas. I mean, I'm pretty cool, but just to take a more serious approach, it's definitely, my actions are definitely going to have to speak louder than my words, because coach knows as well as I know, it's really hard for me. Even, it starts with individual instruction. I gotta be more, come to individual instruction better. I have to start my practices off better. And I just start everything off slow. And I just want to be a better player and mature. And I think if I would have left, I would have just been shooting myself in the foot, because from a mature standpoint, I don't think I was ready.
What makes your team be like?
And
the guys that return, the experience, the equity you have in that?
Honestly, everybody probably knows I'm pretty funny. I was more so thinking about all the new guys and, like, all the jokes I have for them when they come in. I honestly wasn't thinking about that. That's, I was thinking, the freshmen coming in. I wanted to see how I was when I came in as a freshman. PK used to laugh at me and stuff after my first individual. I want that experience, as a senior. Get to see the guys after their first individual. I think it's going to be pretty cool. We got a lot of cool guys coming. I got a chance to meet them when they was here on their visit. And I feel like next season is going to be special. And I get the opportunity to defend a title. Not many people can say that.